Francisco Madero was born on October 30, 1873, in Parras, Mexico, to a very wealthy family. He educated both in the U.S. and Europe. He was also a Mexican revolutionist who strongly believed in change. Francisco Madero was an advocate for social justice and democracy. He was in office for 3 years from 1911 to 1913 due to his assassination. Francisco Madero was most known for challenging Porfirio Diaz for the presidency in 1910. He also operated one of his family farms and improved farming conditions and farming methods for his workers. Madero was loved by the community and had a major support group for his campaign. In 1903, Francisco Madero and Sarah Perez met in San Francisco, where they both studied. Sarah always supported Madero's decision against Porfirio Diaz and in the Battle of Juarez. They married in Mexico City and she tried to better the conditions of the sick, the poor, and the orphans.
Madero was a believer in modern form of democracy and he helped organize the Benito Juarez Democratic Club and a political party in Coahuila from 1904 to 1905. He was unsuccessful to become the governor of state, but he quickly figured a way to throw out Porfirio Diaz out of office. Porfirio Diaz had announced that he was ready to retire in 1910, which caused a flood of political literature and activity. This flood and activity caused Madero to have a successful book called La Sucesión Presidencial en 1910, in which he called for honest elections and mass participation in the political process and for Porfirio Diaz to not get elected as president of Mexico again. The political scene became even more hectic when Diaz changed his mind in 1909 and stated his intention to run for re-election in 1910, which caused Madero to help organize the anti-re-electionist party and became its presidential candidate with the slogan "Effective Suffrage, No Re-election." In 1910, Pancho Villa joined Francisco Madero against the dictator of Mexico, Porfirio Diaz. During the revolution, Villa displayed his talents as a soldier and an organizer with his intimate knowledge of the land, which enabled him to place at Madero's disposal a division of trained soldiers under his command. After the success of the Mexican Revolution, Pancho Villa remained in the irregular army. Pascual Orozco was a Mexican revolutionist who also participated in the beginning of the Mexican Revolution. His army helped fight in the Battle of Juarez between 1910 and 1913 until he helped get Madero assassinated with Victoriano Huerta. As the days got closer to the presidential election, Porfirio Diaz knew that Madero was going to win. The idea of Madero being president angered Porfirio Diaz, which made him get arrested and accused him of insulting authorities and being a rebel. Madero was released on bond and he escaped to San Antonio, Texas, where he wrote the Plan de San Luis Potosí. He wrote it on October 10, 1910, and he declared himself the president of Mexico and called for an armed insurrection to begin on November 20th. In May of 1911, Diaz relinquished power and a provisional government was formed. On November 6, 1911, Francisco Madero was elected president of Mexico, but the next 15 months of his presidency proved that it was difficult for him to keep his promises. Struggles between Madero and the military became heavy. By early 1913, the commander general Victoriano Huerta had turned against Madero and planned to assassinate him. Madero was arrested on February 18, 1913, and he was executed 4 days later by Huerta. Madero is seen as a hero and the father of the Mexican Revolution. Madero was honest and decent and did much to set in motion reforms that would close the gap between the rich and the poor of the people in Mexico.